The South Korean government has unveiled its plans to boost the country's semiconductor industry. This is to secure the country's position as an industry frontrunner and its goal of becoming a major global production hub. Our Lee Rae-hyun with the details.
More investment in the semiconductor industry. That's the plan announced by the Minister of Trade, Industry and Energy on Thursday while visiting a chip material factory in the city of Hwaseong, south of Seoul. The blueprint to boost the chip industry includes three major points. First, to encourage chip-related companies to invest over 300 trillion won, or about 260 billion U.S. dollars in the next 5 years. The administration also aims to boost government spending on essential infrastructure for chip complexes, like electricity and industrial water. There will be more tax benefits, too, for investment in semiconductor equipment and R&D. Tax deductions for large companies that invest in equipment related to nationally strategic technologies like semiconductors will be raised by 2 percentage points to around 8 to 12%. But one expert says those rates need to go higher.
The U.S. and European countries are trying to pass legislation to increase tax deductions for chip-related companies to 30 to 50%. If those bills pass, Korea should raise its deductions by even more.
The second point is training new talent. The government aims to train more than 150,000 people for the semiconductor industry by 2031 and designate graduate schools specializing in chip, which will entitle them to more support for instructors and class materials. The first thing they need to do, experts say, is to bring on more faculty.
Chip-related institutions these days lack faculty. One idea could be to recruit people who work hands-on in semiconductors as instructors.
Also, the government is going to work with the chip industry to establish a semiconductor institution for students, job seekers and other workers in 2023 and train 3,600 people within 5 years. Last but not least, the government will bolster support for R&D in the next generation logic semiconductors. It aims to increase Korea's global market share in logic chips from the current 3% to 10% by 2030. It's also going to provide some 950 billion won, or more than $700 million, for feasibility studies on power semiconductors and automotive chips. Another goal is for Korea to achieve a self-sufficiency rate in semiconductor parts of 50% by 2030 by expanding support for R&D. Lee Rae-hyun, Arirang News.